This is PunkX 2000 and Nero the Brutal, and in a moment we are about to have an interview with Matt Boyce.
This is gonna fail so bad. Fail! Come on, Matt!
Hello, YouTube. This is Matt Boyce. What's up, Matt?
What's up, man? It's exciting.
Happy birthday, by the way.
Thank you. Another year.
Yeah. How old again?
23. I just turned 23.
23?
It's my fourth year in the business. That's what that means. Entering my fourth year. What's up, girl? Hey, we're doing something. Fans, they just won't stop.
I know.
My balloon got stuck up there. Steve-O got it.
Yes. You guys wrong. We're doing something for YouTube. All right?
Fans love you, Matt.
Hey, baby doll. You guys run over there.
Oh, yes, mommy.
That's how it is. Every night, that's how it is.
Yeah, I understand that, Matt. It's got to be awesome. I envy you a bit.
It's awesome.
Okay, like, what I wanted to know is, like, what's it like to be another year older? I mean, I understand, like, with age comes wisdom, but what's your take on it?
For me, every birthday's... it's a good thing because you're still here, still kicking, making another year. That's good. Yeah. But I always dread a birthday.
Oh.
Bye, honey. I love you too. Bye, buddy. But like I said, every year in this business is like 5 years. So you start when you're 18, and as good if you're great when you're 18, 19, 20, then you're a monopoly in the business because you're a young kid who is, you know, beyond his years in ring time. And then when you turn, you know, 22, 23, you're middle-aged in wrestling. So, I mean, I've only got 5-6 more years to get to where I'm trying to go, you know, and that's WWE, of course. So,
oh, wow.
I mean, every year, it's a good thing, but then it's kind of one of those things where you say, I got to step up my game, I got to eat more, I got to gain weight, I got to work out more, you know. And, you know, but it's a good thing, definitely a good thing. I'm still here, and I'm still healthy and not hurt, and every year has been a step up, you know. So
that's a
good
thing.
Good thing. Yeah.
What about any future goals for this coming year? Because, like you said, it's like every year is like 5 years. What do you hope to accomplish this year?
The goal stays
year?
The same, man. Like the goal has been the same since I started wrestling. I turned 18. I knew it's what I wanted to do. Started wrestling. Went you know, as soon as I got the chance, started training. So the goal was gain weight. Get to WWE, get to TNA. I mean, your goal is to do this, and I make a living doing it now, but your goal is to make a good living and, you know, do this for the rest of your life and retire doing this. So my goal is the same as always. You know, I went from 150 pounds when I was 18 to 195 now. So, you know, 10 more pounds and you can be taken really serious. So WWE actually called me today, and they put me on 2 more shows. I'm doing Tulsa in 2 weeks for Monday Night Raw, and I'm doing my hometown, Little Rock, Arkansas, for SmackDown. So,
wow.
You know, things are happening, and things are starting to get more busy and more busy, and just like this week, I've been on the road. This is my eighth day straight to be in a wrestling ring. So it's, you know, it's what we do, and it's what I'm gonna do. So this year is like every other year since I started. I'm working towards my main goal of being where I want to be, where everybody wants to be. That's WWE.
Wow.
That's a long, drawn-out answer.
It works. Last question, because I figure your fans would want to know. What is, in your opinion, the best match you ever had, and for what reason?
Goodness gracious. I've had a lot of really, really good matches. I've wrestled a lot of really good guys. Guys that I've, you know, dreamed about stepping in the ring with, like wrestled Nick Dinsmore, Eugene from WWE, Ricky Morton, Tommy Rich, Jerry the King Lawler.
I've seen you take on Tyson Kidd. I was in the crowd.
Tyson Kidd, I mean, that's, you know, that was what it was. And yeah. It was one of my favorite matches because it was the first time I ever wrestled in front of a WWE audience. I was on worldwide television. That's amazing to me. It was one of those you cry on the way home thinking about where you came from and that, and you know what you just did.
Yeah.
But that wasn't one of my best matches. I mean, even the match I had tonight, like, a lot of people didn't know, but the match I had tonight was with the guy that trained me, that brought me into the business, you know, and I had to compete against him tonight. This was one of my favorite nights just for that reason alone. And then I get to wrestle guys like Derek King on a regular basis, and Derek's probably, if not the best, one of the best I've ever been in the ring with. He's tremendous. So, you can't pick out one match and say it's my favorite, but working guys like Derek, working guys like Allen, Sean Schultz, Shane Williams, I mean, those are my favorite memories, I guess. You know, just doing what I want to do and listening to that guy bang the ring.
Yeah, I heard
jerk.
That.
Will Owens, he's a jerk, folks. In life. Anyway. But, yeah, I mean, so favorite match, I mean, there's just a million of them.
Yeah.
So you can't really answer that question.
Well, I understand.
I mean, God, so many memories.
Well, I thank you for giving me the time, Matt. And
I stumbled upon your YouTube thing, and you do a good job, so keep doing it, man.
I'll do that. Thank you for your time.
No problem, man. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye, guys. Just